So for recreational athletes, you don't have to exercise with your mouth open. You will be able to attain a good work rate with your mouth closed and efficient. Competitive athletes, I would suggest is to alternate between mouth and nose breathing. You don't want to do all of your exercise with your mouth closed because it's going to impose too much of a restriction. So high intensity training, you need that to prevent muscle deconditioning, and you can have the mouth open during this time. So you do high intensity training with the mouth closed, but also do high intensity training with the mouth open. Mouth breathing is going to enable you to push all out, maximum intensity. You get muscle conditioning. Nose breathing is conditioning the breathing. So you're going to do nose breathing, mouth breathing. So that's why when we were looking at yesterday with the Wallabies, they're doing some of their training now, your Australian rugby, national rugby team, some of their training now is done with their mouth taped up. So if you Google that, Wallabies mouth taping, you'll see they only released it about 2 months ago. So for less than maximum intensity training, and at all other times, nose breathing should be employed. We need to be asking athletes, how are you breathing during your sleep? Are you waking up with a dry mouth in the morning? How are you breathing during the day? How is your everyday breathing affecting you? We need to measure their Bolt score. We need to measure the maximum upper tolerance of breathlessness, and we need to improve it. So devote, so this is competitive. During competition, there's no need to intentionally change your breathing. Competition isn't the time to change your breathing. The time to have your breathing good is pre-competition. So you work on your everyday breathing, so then when competition comes, it's optimum.